back to EDU and 90 and happy 2018. We are so excited to kick off season 2 with a topic that many of you requested, how to engage parents and guardians.
That's right. As a middle school teacher, I quickly recognized the importance of involving parents and guardians to help students reach their full potential in the classroom. And on this episode, we'll be looking at some strategies for doing so using G Suite for Education tools. Let's check them out.
Let's start with Google Classroom. One easy way to keep guardians in the loop is with email summaries of students' work in Google Classroom.
Once invited by a teacher, parents and guardians can receive automated daily or weekly email summaries so they're able to stay up to date on what's happening in the classroom. These summaries can include class announcements, assignments, and information on upcoming work or missing work. Next up, Google Sites. Long gone are the days when you need specialized technical knowledge or a designer in order to create a website. With Google Sites, you can quickly and easily create an online hub for your classroom to scalably share information with parents and guardians.
You might consider adding resources for parents and guardians to your site so that they can access information when they need it and without any extra emails or phone calls. Educators will often include their class syllabus, calendars, and information about upcoming events like field trips.
And there are countless other ways that educators use G Suite for Education tools to keep guardians involved and in the loop. Here are a few of our favorites.
For student-led or parent conferences, students can use Google Slides to create digital portfolios of their learning.
By using Google Hangouts, parents can join for conferences virtually or get involved digitally with class events like career days. Google Forms can be used as an easy, paperless way to collect parent or guardian information quickly, whether it's for conference appointments, extracurriculars, or after-school tutoring. And lastly, we heard from many of you that shared docs and sheets could be leveraged to create class newsletters or use as lightweight activity and behavior trackers.
Well, we are out of time for this episode, but let us know in the comments below how you have been using G Suite for Education to communicate and engage with guardians.
And for more EDU 90, be sure to subscribe to the Google for Education YouTube channel. We'll see you next time.
Check out our last episode as we dive into quizzes within Google Forms. And don't forget to subscribe to our Google for Education channel.